Blackstone Audio presents I Hate to Leave This Beautiful Place by Howard Norman. This book is read by Jim Meskimen.
For David St. John. Acknowledgements. For their deep and abiding friendship, Melanie Jackson and Alexandra Altman, and David Wyatt, for all the conversations.
Introduction. Saigyo, a poet and monk who lived in 12th century Japan, wrote, "A soul that is not confused is not a soul." That philosophy served me as a talisman throughout the writing of this book. I kept asking, how does someone with a confused soul, as I consider mine to be, try to gain some clarity and keep some emotional balance and find some joy, especially after a number of incidents of arresting strangeness have happened in a life? I have always felt a bittersweet foretaste of regret when getting ready to leave certain landscapes. The title of this book comes from an Inuit folktale, one you will encounter in these pages, about a man who has been transformed into a goose. As winter fast approaches, he begins to cry out, "I hate to leave this beautiful place." What is remembered here? A bookmobile and an elusive father in the Midwest. A landscape painter whose plane crashed in Saskatchewan. A murder-suicide in my family's house. A Quagmire Inuit rock band specializing in the songs of John Lennon. And in Vermont, a missing cat, a well drilling, and my older brother's requests to be smuggled into Canada. If there is one thing that connects these disparate experiences, it is the hopeful idea of locating myself in beloved landscapes: Northern California, Nova Scotia, Vermont, the Arctic, and of describing how they offered a home for honest introspection, a place to think things through. Often, I just wanted to look at birds for days on end, shorebirds in particular. Still, I would be loath to suggest that life intrinsically has themes, because it does not. In this book, I narrate a life in overlapping panels of memory and experience. When Henry James used the phrase, "the visitable past," he was largely referring to sites that had personal meaning for him: graveyards, archaeological ruins, centuries-old cathedrals. Conversely, this present book contains memories of places that kept refusing not to visit me, unceremonious hauntings, I suppose, which were in equal measure gifts and curses. Since we are seldom stenographers of our hours and days as life unfolds, we remember events with different emotions than those we had when we originally experienced the events, as the haiku master Matsuo Basho put it, and in associative patterns rather than original chronologies. I started this book in the villa of fallen persimmons in Kyoto, Japan,
in a landscape I had previously only read about and seen in paintings and films, but most of it was written in Point Reyes, California, and Vermont, each a beautiful place I always hate to leave.
I hate to leave this beautiful place. Advice of the fatherly sort. On summer evenings in 1964, I used to sit on the basement stairs to read and cool down. This was in Grand Rapids, Michigan. August was particularly steamy, and about 7 o'clock on a Friday late in the month, I sat there and watched my older brother's girlfriend, Paris Keller. "I was named after the capital of France," she said, who was wearing blue jeans, a t-shirt, and sandals, cross her arms, raise off her shirt, and toss it into the clothes dryer. Lavender in color, it had been soaked transparent by rain on her walk to our house. Paris owned a car but liked to take long walks, too. The t-shirt read, "Exist to kiss you," a declaration that was both existential and, for me, at age 15, almost cruelly erotic. She stood there naked from the waist up. The shirt tumbled alone behind the dryer's glass window. Paris looked over at me a few times. We talked a while. I was all but praying that the shirt needed a second cycle. Paris told me her father had been killed in the Korean War. It was the first conversation I ever wrote down. Typed it, Hunt and Peck, on an Olivetti manual typewriter. I made a copy on carbon paper, too. I'm looking at the pages now.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.